Welcome back to my channel. So today's video is a chit chat get ready with me from start to finish on how I achieved this peachy look right here. I really did want to do something super bronzy, super glam, but super easy and not too difficult to achieve and attain. And this is what I came up with. I'm loving it. I'm using a lot of new products and I will talk about them throughout this video because it is a get ready with me. And I do want to say that I am sorry for being absent on the channel these last couple weeks. I've been getting back into the hang of things slowly but surely, and I've had school start back up recently, and I've really just been trying to figure out what it is I want to do with this channel and what my goal is. And sometimes when I take these introspective moments to sort of kind of delve into why I'm doing something, I usually distance myself subconsciously. So that's what happened, and that's why I've been distant. But I'm back and I'm better, and I'm going to be back to posting weekly content. I'm gonna try for like twice a week, but starting back I'm gonna be posting weekly content, and I'm super excited for you guys to walk with me on the journey of this look. So without further ado and without yapping my mouth off more than I am already, let's go ahead and get glam. Okay, so I'm gonna start off with my base, and so for foundation, I'm going to be mixing the Cover FX primer, their illuminating base, and then the Sure Cream from MAC. And we're going to go ahead and hydrate and just prep the skin. So this is like my first get ready with me. I was watching Thomas Halbert's get ready with me, and I absolutely adore him. And he was talking about how he feels like sometimes it's hard for the viewers to sort of kind of, I don't know, relate to an influencer, I guess, and want to like come back and frequently watch their content if they don't really know them as a person. And it can be hard to get to know an influencer when all you see is them teaching you how to do a certain look or something of that nature. And when I was hearing him talk about it, I was realizing that he's right, because even when I watch my faves, I tend to gravitate towards videos of them talking, whether it's about products, whether it's like life updates, whatever it may be. When they're talking, I click on those videos more because I'm like, yo, like, what's going on with you? Like, besides, you know, what you can learn or pick up from people by following them on their social media accounts, videos when they like actually, you know, share bits and pieces of themselves, those are the videos that I'm like, yo, I really effed with this influencer because of how transparent or just real they are. And I realized that there's a lot of that lacking on my channel, and I didn't want to do that. Like, I have not sat down and really done my face from start to finish on my channel since the first YouTube tutorial I ever posted. And so I'm like, I want to incorporate more of me really into my channel, which I haven't been doing. I've been, you know, sort of kind of just doing the YouTube tutorial thing, which I love, don't get me wrong. I love makeup, I love creating and using my face as a canvas, but I do want to include more of me in my channel, if that makes sense. I'm gonna go ahead and set my primer with translucent powder. I'm gonna use the Cover FX Perfect Setting Powder, which is what I usually use or have been using recently. So I just wanna include more of myself, whether that's me talking like favorites videos, which I know you guys love and miss, so I will be doing one for the month of March, or me getting back to why I really started my YouTube channel, which was to give advice. So I'm thinking about bringing that back on my channel in a different way. I'm gonna run it by you guys on Snapchat, because a lot of you guys interact with me more on Snapchat than my YouTube comments. So I'm going to talk about it sometime like within the next couple of weeks on Snapchat and just see how you guys are feeling out me bringing back turban tops in a different way. And if you are an OG, you know what turban tops is. If not, go ahead, you know, creep back in my YouTube videos a little bit, see what I'm talking about. But yeah, so I think that's something I'm going to be implementing back in my channel. For foundation today, I'm gonna be trying the NARS Sheer Glow Foundation in Medium Dark for Macau. I picked this up because of my makeup godmother, Jackie Ina. She loves this stuff, and I've been needing a new foundation because you guys know I have not been wearing a foundation that really is my shade. And I'm just gonna put it on using a pointed foundation brush by Real Techniques, and then I'm gonna go ahead and buff it in using a buffing brush. So I'm gonna go ahead and take my buffing brush, also by Real Tech. I'm gonna buff all of this in. So now for concealer, I'm going to be taking this Tarte Shape Tape in the shade Tan Sand. Now this is my first time getting my hands on this, and I feel like I'm super late because I feel like everybody and their mother has talked about this on YouTube and got their hands on it, but I'm a little late, that's okay. I have heard that it's a little drying, so I'm not sure if I want to like throw it under my under eyes right away. So I'm going to take my NYX concealer by I'm gonna take my HD concealer by NYX and just put a little bit right in this area. In the event that it's a little too drying for my under eyes. So, I do hear like a lot of people complaining that people use too much of this. So that's all I'm gonna put on. It is a little bright. This is hella bright. This is what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna mix a little bit of my LA Girl concealer on top of it. To sort of correct it. Hopefully this works. Thank you. Okay, so I feel like I might have to go down a shade. Because I want to like it. It's really nice coverage. The only issue I'm having is how highlighted I look. And maybe it isn't a bad look. Like, maybe I'll look at the footage and be like, yo, I actually look with being this highlighted. But at the moment, it seems a little bright. I'm not gonna lie. But we're gonna go ahead and set it. I'm using the Perfect Setting Powder again. But before I was cut off by my camera, I was talking about how I think it's important that I incorporate more of myself into my channel, because I really do want this to be like a place where you guys can come and whatever is bothering you, whatever, you know, situation you might be going through, you can come here and you'll be cheered up, you know. You'll forget about your issue, or you'll see something or hear something that I say, or if I have a friend on my channel or collab with someone, hear something that they say that makes your day or changes your perspective on something. If you've been subscribed to me since day one, like OG supporter, then you remember my first video, and in that video I said that that's what I want my channel to be. I always want my channel to be like a safe space, you know, somewhere where if you need something, advice or help through makeup or fashion, whatever it may be, that my channel will be that. And I still mean that. Like, I still wholeheartedly believe that. Like, whatever I put my hands on and incorporate into my channel, I always want it to be something that can help. So to bronze the face, I'm gonna go ahead and use my Too Faced Dark Chocolate Soleil bronzer. So we're gonna go ahead and use fan brush and do the Nikki Tutorials trick. Just because it's faster. Just warm up the face really, really quickly. Bring some depth back in so you don't look too one-dimensional or two-dimensional. I'm so excited because I was watching Desi, my other makeup godmother, Desi Perkins, Snapchat today, and new Key collection is on the way. I'm super duper freaking excited because I didn't need to buy anything from the first Key collection that she did, so I'm definitely gonna be buying some from the current Key collection. We're moving on to the eyes, so I'm just gonna use my NYX concealer to prime my lids because I haven't been really feeling any of my eyeshadow primers lately. Like, they haven't really been doing it for me at all, so I'm just gonna use some concealer. But let me know how you guys feel about having a schedule here on the channel, because for the last couple of months I've just been posting happenstance, like when I feel like it or when it makes sense to me. But I would really like to get you guys opinion on having an actual schedule. Also, not really feeling my nose contour, so I'm gonna try and blend this out as best as I can. Yeah, but I've been thinking about like doing like a schedule type thing for a minute, because I feel like I like that, like having like an actual schedule works for me. And genuinely, like, this is a pattern within my life. Like, when I have a schedule that's set, things just go a lot smoother for me. So let me know how y'all feel about that. I definitely wanna post twice a week. Like, that's my thing. Like, I really wanna post twice a week, but for sure you will get one day, you will get one video a week for sure. But I do wanna get on the habit of doing multiple videos a week, just because I feel like that's, I feel like one video a week is just, it's too much of a gap in content. Like, I feel like because things move so fast on YouTube, like, you just gotta like keep consistently putting out stuff. Good stuff, of course. It will always be quality over quantity for me. So, yeah, but I definitely want to start posting multiple times within a week. Okay, so I'm gonna take a break from my face and stuff. I'm not gonna highlight, but before I move on to the eyeshadow, I'm gonna spray a little bit of my Mario Badescu spray just to set all the powders into each other. So I'm gonna go into Sora, like I said, Marky Dark 6, which is just a Bet blending brush. It's got like a tapered edge. Sometimes I use it for highlight, but today we're using it for blending. Next, for my little makeup geek section, I'm gonna take Chickadee. And I'm going to take that on a Luxie 227 blending brush. I'm going to focus this in this area a little bit under where we just placed that brush shadow. And every single time I place down a shadow, I'm going to go back to my original blending brush, the Morphe R36, to just blend everything out. So mostly this is just placing shadow down. Blend it out. Then I'm going to take this M506 by Morphe and I'm going to mix together Morocco. Well, I'm going to go with Morocco first. And then I'm gonna come in and I'm gonna put a little bit of Sidekick. In Morocco, we're gonna focus right here on the outer corner. And I'm gonna flick it upwards into my crease area. And then go back with my blending brush and blend. Now I'm gonna take a little bit of Sidekick on a brush. To just deepen up Morocco. Then I'm gonna go ahead and cut my crease. And for that, I'm going to be taking Glow Techniques Detailer Brush and my concealer by NYX, if I can find it. There we go. Okay, now I'm gonna feather it. Sort of have to work a little. Even as rounded out and as straight as I can without taking it all the way up to my brow bone. I'm gonna be taking Peach Smoothie, this one right here, and I'm going to set this area with this shadow because it's just going to do the same exact thing that a translucent powder would, which is set the concealer in place. But to add like something to it to make it like pop a little bit, I'm going to take this NYX glitter liner very carefully. I'm going to draw a line where the cut crease stops and sort of kind of fades into like all the other shadows that we got going on. Mm-hmm. You can go over this as many times as you want. But I think I'm gonna stop there because I do have sensitive eyes and these sort of kind of irritate them, but I haven't managed to get my hands on the Urban Decay Heavy Metal liners because they're always sold out. Always. And then for my waterline, I'm gonna be taking the Sephora Contour Matte Gel Eyeliner, and this one is in Caffeine Buzz. Yeah, Caffeine Buzz number 3. So my camera needed to rest, it was getting hot or whatever. So I went ahead and popped on my lashes, and these are Coco Lashes in the style Misha. And these are some of my favorite, just like everyday natural lashes, because they're not too dramatic where you look like you're doing too much for the daytime, but they're enough that they're like attention grabbing and you're like, yo, your lashes are off. So I'm gonna go ahead and take my Nicole Guerrero Glow kits in collaboration with AVH, and I haven't touched this palette since I bought it, and I've had it for like, I don't know, almost a week now, but it's so pretty. Oh my goodness, this is my second glow kit purchase since like the first set came out. Like, I have that glow. So when I saw that this one was coming out, one, I love Nicole Guerrero. She's definitely one of my favorites. I've watched her for a long time now. I knew when like I found out that she was collabing with AVH that I was gonna buy whatever it was. And I was so excited that it was a glow kit. And I love that there's something in here for every skin tone. It's super important to me. So I'm really happy that she took that into consideration when creating this. And yeah, I'm gonna take my Morphe M510 brush and I'm gonna go into Glow Glitter first. It's on the side. Oh my good, you guys, I barely tapped into this. Wow, okay, I'm not overdoing it, because you know how sometimes somebody's like, oh my gosh, look at this highlight, like, girl, you know how much you put on your cheeks. But this is beautiful. I'm actually like really, really shook. That is so pretty. I'm like in love. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead. I'm just gonna use Glow Glitter by itself because I'm liking it a lot. I was literally about to say, I'm gonna put a little bit on my nose, and then I looked at my nose. Definitely didn't do a little, but I definitely haven't highlighted my face in weeks, so I'm a little happy. And whatever's left over. Go ahead and get my fingers off. And I really didn't want to use any other highlight product with this the first time I used it because I wanted to see how intense it was. It's hella intense. I'm gonna take this 132 brush from BH Cosmetics and get my inner corners. Still using Glow Glitter. Oh, and I think I'm gonna put a little bit on my brow bone using a Morphe M508. It's my favorite brush to do this with. I'm obsessed. Now that is taken care of, I'm gonna go ahead and put a little blush on. And for blush, I'm just gonna use Sidekick by Makeup Geek. And now we can move on to the lips. I'm gonna line my lips first using the Downtown Beauty lip liner from NYX. The other day somebody asked me what's the best brand to get lip liner from. NYX, honestly, because they have so many freaking colors and they're not super expensive. For lips, I'm going to be taking this Bite Beauty Multi-Stick in the shade Blondie. It's like a really cute nude. Very similar to Honey Love by MAC, which I know I wear a lot. And I've been wanting to try Bite Beauty for a minute. One, because they're all natural, and I'm super big on anything that's like not harmful to the environment. And then to top it off, I'm gonna put on some gloss, and this is the Sephora number 2 gloss in cappuccino. Super pretty, and I've been really into new glosses. And this is a completed look. I have not been able to say that in almost 3 weeks, and it feels so good. Thank you so much for sticking around. I don't know how long this video is going to be, so if you did make it to the end, thank you so much for watching. As usual, everything will be listed down below in the description box, so if there's anything that I forgot to say or anything that you missed, be sure to check down there, as it will most likely be there. So until my next video, peace, love, and abundance, my loves. Bye! My cheek is booming. This is my shit. No, how am I already out of battery? Stop. Okay.